Welcome to Inkpot. We are starting the course on development theory and experience, and the first topic we'll cover is population and development. In this topic, we'll discuss the interactions and relation between population size, population growth, and economic development. We will be using the chapter 9 from Devraj Rey's book on development economics. The world population is high currently and growing at a rapid pace. The initial increases in world population happened slowly, but due to exponential growth, the recent increases have occurred rapidly, resulting in the threat of a population explosion and its consequences for development. Our interest is to identify the demographic trends and juxtapose them with the patterns of growth and development. If we look at this graph or this map, which has been rescaled according to population size in 2002, we see that the size of some countries or some continents is actually very large compared to their actual geographical size. So if we especially look at India, we know that as a proportion of the entire world area, India does not have such a high area. But if we rescale, or if we are actually showing this map according to population size, so even if India does not have a very large area, so we can see how large is India here, right? In terms of geographical area, India is only this small size, but in terms of population, it occupies a large area in terms of the world population. Similarly, Australia, which is actually quite big, in terms of population proportion, it is very small here, right? Now, let's look at this map, which shows proportion of world population living in poverty. Again, the map has been rescaled. This is not actually how the world looks in terms of the geographical area, but the areas or the regions which have large population, a large poor population, have been blown up or expanded to show their prominence, and other places which have very small poverty or low rates of poverty have been shrunk in size. So we see that Australia, Japan, North America, they are very thin or small here because they have a very small proportion of their population living in poverty, whereas a large area is occupied by Africa and India, and also somewhat in China. So if we compare this graph to the previous one, it is as if the countries which have a high population or the continents which have high population also have a high proportion of poor people. They have higher poverty rates, and this is what these graphs are actually telling us. So using this, we can make some observations. First, which we saw in the first time trend of the world population, that it has increased tremendously over the years. Also, we see that a lot of people are concentrated in developing countries. So we saw that India, Africa had large population size. And there seems to be some kind of a rough negative correlation between population and development. The countries which have high population, like India and Africa, also have low income. So there is a negative or opposite correlation. And on the other hand, US, Australia, which are rich countries, they have a low population also. So this is an interesting pattern that we have recognized, and this chapter basically discusses the reasons behind this kind of a pattern. So these interconnections and interdependence between income and population are what we want to assess and understand properly. So we are going to look at the demographic trends and patterns of growth and development to answer basically four questions. What are the insights about population size and growth we can get by observing the demographic trends? So for this purpose, we'll look at variables such as birth rates, death rates, population growth, and also age distribution and the age patterns. Further, we want to understand what is the correlation between population and development features. Are there any common features of the nations which have high population? and vice versa? Are there any common features of the nations which have low population? And what is the relation between economic development and population growth? How is economic development affecting population growth? Further, we want to understand how do individuals and households make their fertility decisions, and how are these decisions affected by economic development? So fertility means the choice of having children. Alright, how many children do people want to have? How many children do couples or households decide to give birth to? So how are these decisions related to economic development? Does the country's economic status or development status affect these fertility decisions? We are going to look at those socio-economic factors which determine these fertility decisions and fertility choices. Further, let's say the household decides to have Z number of children. Our task next is to understand whether this Z that has been chosen by the households, is it the correct number of children to have from a societal point of view? So we want to understand, or we want to answer the question, are the household level fertility decisions optimal at the social level? Are they socially optimal? So note how we are moving from a positive concern or a positive question. We are trying to answer what determines fertility decisions. So this is a positive question. You would remember the difference between positive and normative from your first semester microeconomics. So here we are just describing or understanding the reasons behind fertility decisions of individuals. Here now we are asking a normative question. The number of children that the people choose to have, is it socially optimal? Is it a good thing? Is it a bad thing? Is it bad for the society or is it good for the society? And what will be the implications of fertility decisions on population growth and size? So these are our normative concerns. Should a couple choose to have Z children on average? Is it a good thing to choose Z children or not? So we are going to delve into these kind of questions. And finally, we also want to understand what can be predicted about the nations which have high population. That is, how does population growth impact development? So note, we are considering both the questions here. We are trying to understand how does economic development affect population size. So from economic development, what implications does it have for population? And the reverse case, how does population affect the economic status or socio-economic development status of a nation? So we are considering both the questions. We want to kind of understand what causes what. Does improved economic development lead to higher population, or higher population lead to low economic development? What is the direction and size of the trend of the causality over here? So these are the questions we will be concerned with in the rest of the chapter. So see you in the next video.